Pages is Apple's free word processing and page layout application, one of which we've covered many times in the past. For this week's tip video, I thought I'd revisit Pages and share some of the features that sometimes get missed. Now, there are two different modes in Pages. The first is word processing mode, and this allows you to create documents that are primarily focused on words and not images, although you can still include images. But the main goal is to accommodate the flow of the written word and allow you to type unhindered and in a linear fashion. Now, you can check which mode you're in, the other mode being page layout, but we'll come to that shortly. You can have a look at the document. You'll see here we've got options here for sections and bookmarks. This is indicative of us being in word processing mode. And also, if you go to File, you can see we can actually convert this to page layout mode if we want. But a word of warning, if you're in word processing mode and then you do convert to page layout, you will lose your body text. And that's the sort of like the main text that you might have typed in. So the best thing is really to decide initially which mode you want to be in before you create your document. Another way to check which mode you're in is to go to View and then say Show Layout. You'll see here we have a header, a footer, and this big block in the middle here is your body text. And this is where you enter your text. Let me just enter some text and I'll show you something else that happens within word processing mode. If I switch on page thumbnails, now we have a single page, but I could add pages here if I want to. But the nice thing is with word processing mode, because it is intended for you to sort of get into the flow of writing, it will actually create new pages if the text overflows. So let me just put some text into my pages document to begin with. So let's create a couple of pages of text about my favorite 1960s sci-fi program. But as I reach the bottom of this first page, if I just stop typing, and then if I carry on at this point, and then continue typing, you'll see a second page is created automatically at the end of the first page. And if we carry on even further, if we have more text than will fit on the second page, it will automatically create the third page for us. So let's just carry on. There we go. There's our third page. And then if I stop typing, you'll see that the page thumbnails in the sidebar are updated to show the three pages. Now, although this is primarily for text, you can add images to here as well. It's very straightforward. If I go across to Safari, I've got some images here. I can just drag an image from Google Images, drop it in. That will insert it. And there's some formatting options here as well. So if I go to Format, I've got the image selected. I can move this around. And you see by default, the text will wrap around the image. I've got it set to move with text. You can get it to stay on the page if you want, and the text wrap is automatic. If I wanted to change that for the text to wrap around the image, I can click here, and you'll see as I move this around, I can get the text to move around the image as well. And there's all sorts of spacing and text fit options here as well. Another really useful option within Pages is the ability to use things called styles. And this allows you to apply consistent formatting across text. And you can also create your own customized styles as well. So let me just show you how to do this. We'll change the body style. So this is our body text that we've got in these linked text boxes. Let's say I wanted to change this to a different font. So if I select this first paragraph, go to Format, you'll see it selected its body style. Let's change the format to something else. Let's say Noteworthy. Now, as you can see, it's changed the style of the text that I had selected, but it hasn't changed the other body text style. To do that, what you have to do is to say Update, and you'll see the Update All Paragraphs that use this style. Now, all of my text, all my body text, is changed to this particular style. Let's say that you perhaps didn't want to have, you wanted to keep the original body style, but perhaps have a customized body style. Let's go ahead and do a similar process. We'll select some text. We will change the font of this text to, let's say, Baskerville. Okay. Now, rather than change the body style by updating, what we can do is click on this box here, hit the plus, and let's call this new body. Okay, and now you'll see that this paragraph here has got the new font. This has got the original font. So if I wanted to change this text here to have this font, I would just go to New Body, and there we go. Now this is done on a paragraph by paragraph basis. So you'll see there's lots of different styles here, titles, subheadings, headings, etc. Actually, a quick tip, if you want to create a shortcut, if you click on here and say shortcut, let's say we wanted it to be F8. So now if I go across and select a paragraph, say this paragraph here, and I want this to be the new body style, if I hit the F8 key, you'll see that set it to the new body style with a simple keystroke.